administrative duties after serving for many years on the association's executive committee. In 1979, NBAOPO members elected Seward Nielsen to the executive committee. After serving 3 years as vice president and 5 years as president, Seward moved into the interpreter role in 1987, a position he held for the next 33 years. Seward helped to direct and educate two generations of officials across the province. To thank Seward for his 4 decades of administrative service, the NBAABO would like to present him with this engraved gold watch. Thank you, Seward. The highest officiating award presented by Canada's Basketball Officiating Commission is the Ted Early Memorial Award. Criteria for this recognition include being a superior official at the local, national, and international levels, having served in administrative and leadership roles both provincially and nationally, and contributing in an educational manner to assist in the advancement of fellow officials. Having checked every one of these boxes and then some, this year's recipient of Canada's Basketball Ted Early Award is St. John's Seward Nielsen. Congratulations, Seward. Presented by Adam Humphrey. St. Malachy's High School Saints. The Saints were pushed into playoffs where they had to win a tough regional final against Fredericton High School in Fredericton and then had to come from behind late to win the sectional final at home against Kennebecasis Valley High. NBIAA All-Stars Clancy McIntyre and Avery Alward will try to lead this team to their first AAA girls banner for the school. Miramichi Valley High School, Palamu. The Palamu had the easiest path to TD Station as they finished first in the Northeast League to earn the right to host a sectional final for their only playoff game. The Palamu are led by their 2 NBIAA All-Stars, Georgia Bell and Erica Ma, and they are looking for their first AAA Girls Championship school in school history. Ladies and gentlemen, the non-starters for the visiting St. Malachy's Saints. Number 1, Ava Mason. Number 2, Jenna Higgins. Number 6, Allison LeBlanc. Number 9, Gwen Shannon. Number 11, Lauren Wells. Number 12, Ashley Bro. And number 13, Grace Collins. And now your starters. Number 3, Rhea McFarlane. Number 5, Ella Hoyt. Number 7, Avery Alward. Number 8, Layla Burns. And number 10, Clancy McIntyre. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the non-starters for the Miramichi Palamu. Number 5, Gracie Burns. Number 6, Avery Scott. Number 9, Olivia Kelly. Number 12, Addison Swain. Number 13, Gracie Goodfellow. Number 14, Tyra DeRush. Number 15, Riley Duffy. And now your starters for Miramichi Valley. Number 3, Erica Ma. Number 4, Georgia Bell. Number 7, Mariah Ward. Number 8, Brooke Reynolds. And number 10, Lily Sisk.
Head coach Jim Waters. Head coach for St. Malachy's, Dan Patterson. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise if you are able and remove your hats and join Lily Van Beek in the singing of O Canada.
Fans, here we go. Welcome to the first of the AAA finals.
The officials
of the last
for
night of the final 12
game
here from TD Station in St. John, New Brunswick on AO Live. My name's Dave Tingley. Thanks for joining us, fans. You can find me at Hoops Tingley on Twitter or Instagram or anywhere else you guys out there in TV land know me, but it's a madhouse in here already. The local team in the final, and here we go with the tip. And St. Max wins that tip. Avery Allward trying to get it ahead to Ella Hoyt and turnover right away to the Pulamu. So this is a game in which the Pulamu got blown out by the Saints their first meeting and then beat them the last time around. It's a favored Saints team, but a well-coached and talented Pulamu team can certainly give the Saints a matchup here, as Clancy McIntyre couldn't handle that long pass there from Hoyt. And back to the Pulamu. And it's going to be loud. There's a lot of St. Malachy's fans here in the red and white. It's a loud defense chant. Oh boy, that's a heck of a defensive play there from Hoyt. Helping out on the penetration by Georgia Bell, the all-star guard for the Pulamu. Two all-star guards in the backcourt, Ma and Bell. There goes Bell, the handoff. Sisk on the drive. Coming around is Ma. Oh, Ma wanted. Yeah, wanted to hook up with Reynolds there, but no can do. A little 1-3-1 here for the Pulamu. St. Max, a big team, got lots of inside presences. They want to touch the ball in that paint. And the Pulamu want to extend things and make it hard to get in there, and they're doing a good job so far. Although that was a nice little look inside. The turnaround by Layla Burns was no good. And Bell ripped it away, and it's a 1-2 and a 3 from the wing. Ma with an air ball, and the fans in St. Max let her know about it. Another possession though. Oh yeah, it's gonna call for a travel, yeah. Well done, the defense of Hoyt out top. She's a pest out there as Ella Hoyt. She's going to STU next year. And double jointed, she popped a shoulder out in a game and then popped it back in and continued to play. So we got some toughness here on the floor, in case you were wondering. These girls are ready to play. That's long on that one from McIntyre, but the rebound found its way to Layla Burns. She missed, but run down in the corner by Burns. Hoyt swings to McIntyre. McIntyre has an open Rhea McFarland. She's side hit the side of the backboard with that one. They're a little nervous here, I think, early. These shots are pretty wild from pretty talented offensive players. You can see why. Playing in this gym, it's hard to describe going from playing in a high school gym to playing in an open arena like this with a different background. It just is. That's going to be a wing perimeter jumper that's long there from Layla Burns, and it's going to be tied up as grabbing that rebound was Sisk, but she was immediately tied up, but it's going to go back to the Pulumu. So still round numbers on the scoreboard here, a little over 2 minutes in. 7:55 clock running first quarter, the AAA girls championship game of the NBIAA here from TD Station. And a nice move inside, but there was McIntyre coming over to pick off that pass of Georgia Bells, but knocked out of bounds. And it's going to stay with the Pulumu. The boys team just lost the AA final. These girls want to step up and play AAA, as is their want. If they want to, they can do so. Steal there over there. And a good hands by Avery Allward knocking that pass down. Allward gets it back. Pulls up for the perimeter jumper. Not there in the rebound. Skying for that one was Georgia Bell. Oh, boy, the defense for Ella Hoyt. And the cut from Ella Hoyt. Oh, the defense right back from Georgia Bell. Oh, the denial. Gorgeous defensively. And both of these teams struggling, but it is the defense is the story early. They're making it tough. That was a rare open jumper, though, that was missed. And Sisk almost traveled, but got it to Ma. Ma being harassed there by Hoyt, but beat her on the crossover, got into the paint. She had a shot there from the foul line, didn't want it. Pardon me, that's Ma, excuse me. That was Avery, Mirai Ward, pardon me, hand on the ball, excuse me. That was Ma on the penetration. She didn't get it to go. Almost got the steal, but going back to the Saints. Pardon me, fans, I'm gonna get some names wrong early. I haven't seen these teams play as much as I'd like to, certainly. Oh, that was a pretty pass inside. And finally, Clancy, some crooked numbers McIntyre on the board. It goes to St. Max, Clancy McIntyre on the lefty lay-in, and it's 2-0 Max here, a little over 3 minutes in. Nice little hesitation by Bell. Got it to Ma. Pardon me, that was, yes, Ma on the penetration. She was too strong with that layup attempt. And the pull-up and two more. Rhea McFarland. Tickled the twines, and it's 4-0 St. Mary's, almost 4 minutes in. Little screen roll action there for Bell. She kicks to the corner, and Ma is going to try that swinging right-hander again. This time, she gets it to go. Erica Ma with the two-point first two for the Pulumu. And then the steal. No, yes, but out of bounds off of Ella Hoyt. Well done by Ma. Good anticipation getting off the floor, knocking that pass down. And the defense chant from the St. Max fans rings out in this arena. It's going to be loud in here all night. Georgia Bell using that screen. Well defended by Max, but in the corner, a wide open three. Hits the side of the backboard for Mariah Ward. Again, just a little nerves, I think, into play here. Clancy McIntyre up ahead of the field. Can't lay it in. Well defended there by Mariah Ward. And Sisk ripped away that rebound and got it to Georgia Bell. Hands off to Sisk. That's Reynolds handing off again to, ooh, she had a wide open lane, did Bell. Chose to kick it to Ma. Now they're against the clock and they've got to get one up, and it's Sisk. But she's short with that lefty jumper. In there, digging it out is Mariah Ward, and now on the drive, too strong is Ma, rebounded by Hoyt. She got it to McIntyre. McIntyre, she's going to go into the lane. She kicks it back out for Avery Allward. Allward tries a three, no good. The box out by Sisk, and then the foul coming in by Ella Hoyt, chopping down on Sisk on that rebound. Subs in for the Pulumu. Avery Scott, Tyra DeRoche, and Riley Duffy, but that's going to be after our first timeout. Timeout St. Max. And this place is rocking. What a great atmosphere. There's been some good atmospheres all week, but it's always different when there's a local team in one of these AAA finals. You can always expect these bigger schools locally to draw a ton of fans, and I think you're going to see a ton of fans tonight for the boys' final, Leo Hayes and FHS. Guarantee, I can guarantee you there's been some fans that have driven down from FHS, from Fredericton, to watch both of those teams. So that'll be a fun later game. But this one's fun so far. Not a lot of scoring. 4-2 early St. Max halfway through the first quarter. But a spirited battle already. Defense is ringing out so far. St. Max has really been that team at the top of the everybody's list on the AAA side. So of course, everybody expects FHS to be good year after, and they are usually year after year. This year, Miramichi Valley took care of them last weekend in that matchup, prevent them from getting back to the Aiken Center, back to this TD. Sorry, fans, I'm still back in the 90s when I played in the, when we played in the Aiken Center, into TD Station. So Miramichi Valley took care of business on that side. That's why they're here facing these slightly favored St. Malachy Saints. A missing missed layup in there, that running right-hander from Avery Scott. A little bit strong, and St. Max now here trying to push out their two-point lead to a 4 or 5-point lead. It's these points have been hard to come by both ways. McIntyre spins, and then a little Euro step out of the spin. Boy, that was some good control there by Clancy McIntyre. She spun, and then she kind of angled the body further by. She is long and tough, and that is a missed inside from Georgia Bell, and coming back the other way. There was a follow there attempt by Avery Scott that was blocked. Pardon me, that was Sisk, I think, on the follow attempt, and McIntyre tries to turn the corner, no good. Really well defended there from the Pullman. Sisk comes away with it. Georgia Bell, she's got to get it over. Ooh, she only did with a second to spare, not even. Some dribble handoff action here now. Bell, she looks to take a three, and it's blocked. Allison LeBlanc, who on the floor for the Saints. The good defense there on the All-Star. Oh, and McIntyre again squeezes through the good body control, but can't finish this time. Rebounded there by Tyra DeRoche, and on the push now, Avery Scott. And a travel back to the Saints. So, and the Saints chant of, you can't do that, Avery Scott. It's going to be a pretty good atmosphere here tonight. Oh, that's good hustle to get back by Sisk and knock it out of bounds. Had a 2-on-1 there momentarily. A little too much under the pass, air under the pass there from Avery Allward. She had it knocked away. It's Layla Burns for the Saints. Into Allward. Allward, a little screen there, and screen a roll from the point guard, Ella Hoyt, but she went to McIntyre. Now McIntyre with the running lefty hook doesn't go. Rebounded in there by DeRoche, and she gets hit. That's going to be McIntyre. That's her first foul. Only two fouls in the first quarter period, both on the Saints. 6-2. Pulumu really having a tough time scoring. They're getting that. They're putting the ball on the deck and getting into the paint. Look at that stop and go maneuver. Oh, that's a wide open three. Can she get off the Schneid? She can. Bottom for Lily Sisk. A big three for the senior. From the corner, back to 6-5. Pulumu. A little pressure from Miramichi Valley that Saints handled just fine. Stepping into a three to get it right back there was Avery Allward, but no one rebounded by Sisk. And she pushes to Avery Scott. Avery Scott gets the ball under control. Georgia Bell on the penetration. She's too strong, but a rebound in there for Mariah Ward. Another three doesn't go, but Georgia Bell in there knocks it to Sisk. Sisk backdoor, pretty feed. The fine and the lefty lay-in.
Riley Duffy.
From Riley Duffy. Pardon me, new on the floor, Riley Duffy. Oh, and Duffy rotates over nicely to meet Clancy McIntyre. Prevents a lay-in, but puts her on the line. That's a good foul, actually. Well done by Duffy. I think I said Mariah Ward fans. Pardon me. I've got some of these. I'm an old man, and some of these lighter numbers can look a little funny from across the floor to my old eyes. These yellow numbers. Oh, man. When girls got long hair, it's the bane of an announcer. 1 for 2 at the line. Oh, and a nicely done by Sisk. That was smart. She knew that she'd been reached over there and got it tipped. So instead of trying to go after it and save it, she just kept boxing out, pushing out McIntyre, and let it roll out of bounds. So pushing the pace is DeRoche. A little dribble handoff action, and Hoyt over there being a pest. Didn't let it happen easy. Scott there had it knocked away by Hoyt, out of bounds. Staying with the Blue. We're tied at 7 here. Minute 55 less first quarter of a defensive battle here. TD Station. DeRoche with the crossover, but Hoyt all over it. Oh, she's going to fit in well with Fred Connors at Stu next year. Just getting on, digging it out down there on the floor, forcing a turnover. A little double team from the Pulumu there. Gets it over the top to Layla Burns, and then stolen. Nicely done by Ma. Oh, and coming back is Clancy McIntyre. Stealing it right back. Ma generated the turnover. McIntyre. Ma meets her way out by the half court line. Boy, that was good. 1-2. That was good play by the Saints. McIntyre found Hoyt, found LeBlanc. 9-7 max. And Ma points at her chest going, oh, that's on me. I was too wide. She was out of bounds. She ran out of bounds there to caught that pass. She knew it right away. Banged her chest, said, sorry, Georgia, my bad. So 9-7 Saints, 1:10, clock running first quarter. Ma out there harassing Rhea McFarland. Over to Hoyt. Scott's on her, but Hoyt beats it. Oh, rotating over was Georgia Bell, but gave her a little hip check, and Hoyt's going to the line for 2 free throws. 1:01 on the clock. Checking out's going to be Avery Scott, and back in is Mariah Ward. Scott's now got her, that's only her first foul, so 2 fouls either way here, first quarter. So no impending foul trouble, certainly, for anybody here. But it's been physical. It hasn't been. Oh, and Hoyt missed it, and then nobody stuck her box out. She got it right back. She's going to try a 3, and it's in.
Hello,
Hoyt just exchanged 2 for 3. I don't want free throws. I want 3-pointers, says Ella. Well, she's up there playing D on Tyra DeRoche. DeRoche finds Ward. Oh, boy, look at those hands. Oh, yeah. Very aggressive from Hoyt. She gets caught that time. That's going to be 2 on her. That's the problem there. You love the aggressiveness, but you don't want 2 early on your defensive, not specialist, because she can play 0-2, but you know what? She's one of your best defensive players. Such a pest there at that guard spot. Trying to run a little dribble handoff action here is the Pulumu. They miss that 3, and the rebound comes to Avery Allward, and she's going to push. Avery, big kid that can handle the ball, but that was not a good pass and picked off by Georgia Bell, who got it up to Ma, who was then smacked. Only the first on. Looks like it was on Rhea McFarland. So 11 on the clock, 10. First quarter. Georgia Bell turns the corner, tries to drop it down in there. She does, but the ball swung all the way around to Ma. Ma trying to squeeze through, and she's going to get hit. Coach Patterson strongly felt that that hand was on the ball. Looked to me at live action like it was as well. Ma in and out on the free throw. So St. Mac's up 12-7 here. They're, they only have 2.7 seconds to get a shot off. This should be the last play of the quarter, and Ma misses them both. Allward pulls it in. McIntyre's not going to have enough time to get it up. And we're going to the first quarter break. St. Malachy's Saints, the favorites. Defensively, throwing a blanket around these Pulamoon. It's 12-7 early. I need to learn what these chants are from the St. Malachy's fans. They got sink the boat over there. Do they think a Pulamoo is a boat? I don't know. I can't figure out these signs. I'm not sure. I'm generally confused, fans, so it's not a shocker that I can't figure out what the Saints are referring to, the Saints fans, but I'm sure it's something smart and I'm just the dumb one, but I don't know what sink the boat means. A Pulamoo's a fish. All right? I don't know if you guys know that. So somebody text these Saints fans if they don't know the Pulamoo's a fish. Samu the Pulamoo. I mean, you fish for a Pulamoo in a boat because it's a type of a boxing salmon, as we talked about in the guys' game last game. So, fans, if you haven't listened to a game yet this weekend, I have a little segment every game, you know, where it is, I've seen it on Wikipedia, so it must be true. And that was the part I saw on Wikipedia about Miramichi Valley. It's Samu the Pulamoo, a boxing salmon. So the school's a school of 500 in a town of 17,700 approximately. Miramichi Valley, they can play AA, but you can choose to play up if you want to challenge for the AAA title in a sport in a given year and you think you got the team to do it. Miramichi Valley clearly does. So they're playing up this year, and these Saints, a school of about 600 in St. John, established in 58 as a boys' Catholic school. And now an enrollment of 600 guys and girls. And a terrific girls' basketball team this year. And a loud contingent cheering them on. So it's Pulamoo ball starting the second quarter. In it comes. To Georgia Bell. Hasn't gotten her offense going yet. This Georgia. Ma turns that corner. Boy, she's deadly going that way. Erica Ma, they bring her left to right across that defense. Oh, yeah, that's going to be up and down. It is. Well done by Bell. Yes, it was Bell and Ward that met up with Layla Burns at half court and forced that turnover. 12-9, St. Max. Pulamoo ball. Georgia Bell now turns the corner. Didn't want the three, but wants the drive. That's Brooke Reynolds, but she's blocked. Oh, and Waters almost slipped and fell. Jimmy on the sideline popping up there. There's a little elevated, slightly elevated is the floor off of the main floor, about 6 inches there. Jimmy originally thought they had called it the other way. He was trying to jump to his feet to protest. Didn't have to. Almost lost his life, but he gained control. Sisk now, a little handoff to Bell. Bell's going to pop a three. Oh, and it's good.
Georgia
brings the bell from three and ties it up. We got a dozen each here. TD Station, 9:10 clock running second corner. NBIA AAA final. There is Mariah Ward stepping in coast to coast. The theft and the deuce. And the Pulamoo with their first lead. Oh, nicely done. The Allward with the catch. Oh, that was beautiful stuff from Avery Allward. That was not an easy catch on a long pass. She just knocked it down with one hand, controlled it, and got it up on the glass. And there is a vocal contingent from Miramichi Valley countering the Saints on the opposite side of the floor. The shirtless fellas are back with the from the boys' game. They stepped out for some food, I think. Now they're back. You boys, you got to get in order. Remember, it's not VMHS or SMVH. You got to make sure you're in the right order over there. Oh, they're getting themselves organized. They should have gotten three more and gone with Pulamu, if that's me, but... Oh, nicely on the reach in there, trying to disrupt Bell. But Bell split it. Got away from Ava Mason there. It was new one on the floor for the Saints and harassing Miss Bell out top. So 14-13, one-point lead. Miramichi Valley. Bell gets into the lane with the left hand. Oh, and she gets it to go. That wasn't an easy finish. She got it up on the rim, and she got the right English on it and spun it in. Avery Allward's about to be trapped over there. Oh, boy, out of bounds. Luckily off of Sisk. Bell was hunting her from behind, wanting that any spin, or she was going to be a party to that. Oh, that's a long pass. Oh, boy, Avery Allward caught. Get up, finish. Rise and splash from Avery Allward. Confident looking stroke from Avery. He's a big kid who can step out and make it. 16-15. Sisk on the penetration with the left hand and a finish. Beautiful from Lily Sisk, the grade 12. Good call. Push up the sideline there from Burns, beating the pressure. Looks like that was Sisk over there. Yeah, Sisk over there on the sideline. Mason back out. Hoyt returns. 18-15, 7:53 on the clock. Pulamu by three over the favored Saints. Another piece there from Georgia Bell, and another piece. Bell out there. Some harassing defense on the sidelines. These deflections matter almost as much to coaches as steals. They get this team out of rhythm and make it more difficult for them to get into their offense. That's going to be two now quick ones on Lily Sisk. She's going to have to come out, I think. Yeah, she is. Avery Scott played well so far. She's going to check back in. Oh boy, Clancy McIntyre almost ran over Georgia Bell there in the corner, then a wild pass looking for, I think it was Allward they were looking for over there on the other side. No can do. Georgia Bell against the defense of Layla Burns, beats her. She got number, she's gonna pull up and shoot. Almost looked like she didn't want to. It looked like she wanted to drop a pass off. Just kind of looked awkward. So 18-15, 7:28 clock running. Second quarter, Triple A championship game, St. Max and Miramichi Valley. It's been a good one. It's the consensus from the experts, and I'm using my air quotes on that, is McIntyre not able to finish off that long pass in the out of bounds. Ma's gonna try a three, back rims it. Rebounded by Allward. Allward now. Use it for McIntyre. Oh, that's going to be picked off, and it is. Well read. Excellent work by Avery Scott. She goes coast to coast and lays it in. And Miramichi Valley by five. And then almost a steal there on the sideline. Mariah Ward getting over and knocking it out of bounds. So the Pulamu putting their stamp on this second quarter. Oh, and well read again by, wow, Erica Ma, but then McIntyre came over and stole it right back. Looked like Ward had the rebound there, but then got kind of knocked off balance. No call, but then going baseline and stepping out of bounds that time with St. Max, and it's right back to Miramichi Valley. Handoff. Integral handoff action. And now on the attack. Going left-handed and getting it rejected by Allward. was Brooke Reynolds. Allworth shutting the door over there. Checking into the game, Olivia Kelly. Gwen Shannon, grade 10 from St. Malachy's, checking in. 8 seconds left, and there goes Mal driving right. Comes all the way back to Bell. She's got to put it up at the buzzer, and she's going to be arrived wide right. And she's going to hear it from the St. Mac's fans. Ma watching closely the top of this zone. The award's going to try a long three, side rim. Rebounded and tied up. That's Hoyt. Hoyt and Reynolds, neither one of those two are going to give an inch. I'll tell you that right now. Ma trying to steal that pass, but it made it to McFarland. Another little, oh boy, that's a long three. Back rim by Hoyt. And Ma comes in for the rebound, gets it knocked away from McFarland, but right back to her. Now it's going to be an open three for Bell. Doesn't go. Knocked back to Ma. Ma stepped in. Can't finish. And offensive rebound by Reynolds up, and she's hit. She's going to go to the line for two free throws. So the Pulumu have made this their type of game. Max not getting the touches inside that they want to be getting. That's for sure. And the Pulumu are doing their thing on the offensive end. Getting that ball into the paint. They've missed some bunnies. But really, they've outplayed St. Malachy's here so far. And they're keeping things on the perimeter. Oh, knocked away by Ma. That's going to stay with the Saints, but that's going to take a lot of time off the clock. That's why I say deflections are oftentimes just as valuable as, almost as valuable as steals. Checking back in is DeRush and Duffy from Miramichi Valley. Boy, pushed up to Allworth. Allworth now looks to, doesn't get in the paint. Another three by St. Malachy's. Looks like it's going to stay at this end, yeah. McFarland in there got held. Looks like by, was it Reynolds? Tyron DeRoche, pardon me. 5-11, looks like, and there goes Miramichi again, packing it in, and then the steal. Ma, she's got numbers. Oh boy, well played by McFarland. Read it like a book, exactly where Ma was trying to go. Got it right back for the Saints. They're stuck 7, though, under 5 now. Second quarter, Allworth, the high post. Another 3 for St. Malachy's. This time, number 3 with the 3, Rhea McFarland, a big shot for the Saints, down to 4. Coach Waters, he's going to want a timeout next opportunity. And again, Ma to the right. She gets downhill going that way. And she's tough to stop. They get out to her there. And she still turned the corner. They had to foul her to put her on the line. And she's going to have 2 shots when we come back from this timeout. 4:32 on the clock. And that's going to be a huge foul. Yeah, and I'm in agreement. When I looked up, that's a strange one. That's on Hoyt with her 3rd. 4.5 left, and it looked to me like it couldn't have possibly been on her either, but that's the way the refs had it. The refs had it for Ella Hoyt, and that is a problem for St. Malachy's, a big problem. Looked to me like she was the one guarding the initial drive. I wish we had I didn't glance at my replay screen here. Maybe we saw it and I was too busy doing other things. But that, when she turned the corner, I think the initial defense was Hoyt. But when she turned the corner, it looked like somebody else stepped in there, McFarland, I think, but the call goes against her, and Coach Patterson is upset with that one. And now, stepping to the line for two free throws is Ma, trying to push this lead out from four. She's going to contend with a lot of noise over there. But she gets her to go. Somebody with a lot of breath over there. or a siren with a good... with a very annoying noise, one or the other, but didn't matter to Ma. She went 2 for 2. And all words too high there for McIntyre. Turnover back to the Pulumu, up 6 as we approach 4 minutes left, first half. Spinning into the lane, it's Hoyt, and then she just explodes to the rim. Can't finish, but coming in, following there was Reynolds. No, pardon me. That was Riley Duffy, excuse me. Wasn't able to get it to go either. Good ball movement this time by Max. A long jumper, though, from McIntyre. Wasn't there, and then turnover. The outlet pass hit somebody in the back of the head. I think it was Duffy. That's good. Yeah, she forced a travel. I was going to say it looked like... thought for a moment that was going to be a foul call there on Duffy, but she was just in the right place there defensively. Forced to travel, and it's back to Miramichi Valley. 3:41 clock running, second quarter. AAA Girls Championship for the NBIA banner. Bell now. Oh, got Allward off her feet. Didn't attack, though. Ma's going to. That first step is lightning. Just couldn't finish. Got all the way to the 10. Man, she's fast with the ball in her hands. Erica Ma. Almost created. Oh, that is a pretty feed inside to McIntyre. Rhea McFarland hit her right on the hands. That was not an easy one to throw or catch, but execution was perfect. Hand off to Ma. DeRoche now to Bell. Bell a little back in and a step around. Oh, that was a lovely move, but she couldn't finish. She got the rebound, but then got it knocked away, and it's back to St. Malachy's. Oh, that was a nice move. Just that lefty runner rimmed out. Oh, that was travel. Yep, absolutely. Right call. McFarland just a little bit out of sync. So Miramichi Valley's done a terrific job of keeping the ball out of the paint for St. Max. St. Max wants it down there as much as possible, and they've done a good job keeping it on the perimeter. They've made a couple threes of St. Max, but Miramichi Valley probably feels like they should be leading this by a little more, but they've missed a lot of bunnies. And against the clock, Ma gets it up, tries to bank it home, almost does. Rebounded by Allward, who's been terrific, and Ma with another steal. She's going to attack the glass. She goes right at Allward. Allward, though, with the block. Shutting the door. A little flex from the fans in the crowd for Avery. She turned it over and then turned it away. The attempt from Ma. Ooh, boy, almost a 5-second call, but Bell was able to secure. She's backing in. Goes up with the right hand. Misses. McIntyre. Got it smacked away, and Danny Patterson going, oh man, one time we had a break, but I think he didn't realize that that was a fifth foul, and they're going to shoot some free throws. We'll see who that foul was on. That's going to be 2. Yeah, 2 on Riley Duffy. First shot goes in for McIntyre. Second one, not so good. Oh boy, we got some trouble back here for the Pulumu, but Ma was able to come back and collect. wide open three for Tarush. It's online, but it's long. Rebound in there, though. Up and in by
Riley
who?
Duffy.
I can't see it. It's Riley Duffy, though, coming in with the lay-in. And Duffy's had some good minutes off the bench. I didn't mean to make that sound so surprising, but no, she's been terrific. Oh, and the spin. Oh, boy. Going to the bag of tricks was Clancy McIntyre. And DeRush, she's going to have to win the foot race off the sideline. She does. Gets it to Ma. And Ma didn't turn the corner there. Little dribble handoff action. DeRush going to try another three. Side rimmed it and rebounded there by Scott. Scott now. She's going to try to get into the lane. Throws up a wild one, but rebounded by Membership Valley. And now another three attempted, and it's good. Erica Ma. Nothing but nylon from downtown, and now Max is in trouble. They got to get it over fast. Oh, and they barely do. Oh, and short on that jumper there was Allison LeBlanc. Out of bounds, back to Miramichi Valley. 6-point lead in the ball, 52.3 left. First half. Jenna Higgins now into the game, number two for St. Max. Ashley Bro also into the game, the grade 10 guard for the Saints. Trying to protect some people from fouls here late. Ma on the penetration again, gets to her right every time, turns that corner, causing so much havoc. I have a suggestion for St. Malachy's. Make her go left. See what happens. Just try it. Just once. We'll see how that goes. Easier said than done, though. That first step of Maz is absolute lightning. Oh, boy. And a big three. That looked online, but short from Avery Scott. And now St. Max has a chance here to bring this lead back down a little bit. McIntyre likes it in the post. She's going to do a step back. It's blocked. Oh, boy. And collected nicely and spun in. Boy, that's a big hoop. For Ashley Bro. Didn't play all half, comes in, makes the biggest play of the half for one of them for St. Max. Another open three, no, long. Avery Scott collects and pushes, and McIntyre's got 2 seconds. She's got to throw it up. She does at the buzzer. Oh, back rim. That would have been big for Max, but it's a good last minute for the favorites. They creep back to four, 29-25. And the story of that half is the Bulamu making some shots and keeping St. Malachy's out of the paint. It's been a good formula so far. We'll see if they can continue when we're back here in about 9:45. We'll see you then.
Each year at the NBIA Final 12, basketball Nebraska honors a deserving team in each of the male and female AAA, AA, and single A divisions with a Fair Play Award. This award is voted on by all NBIA coaches and is presented to the team that exemplifies outstanding behavior and sportsmanship throughout their season. It's with great honor that basketball Nebraska present this year's award in the AAA Girls to St. Malachy's Saints. Presenting the Fair Play Award is Lori Wall of Basketball the Brunswick. Accepting the award is St. Malachy's Junior Girls Team. Congratulations, Saints.
First, a summary of stats. Avery Allward, one personal foul, 3 points. Clancy McIntyre, one personal foul, 10 points. Rhea McFarland, 2 personal fouls. 5 points. Ella Hoyt, 3 personal fouls, 3 points. Allison Malone, 2 points. And Ashley Burns, 2 points. Miramichi Valley, Brooke Reynolds, 1 personal foul, 2 points. Lily Sis, 2 personal fouls, 5 points. Erica Ma, 9 points. Georgia Bell, 1 personal foul, 5 points. Mariah Ward, 2 points. Avery Scott, 2 points. Tyra DeRush, 1 personal foul. Riley Duffy, 2 personal fouls, 4 points. Layla Burns. Thank you.
on a missed jumper there, but rebounded nicely by Grace Collins on the floor for St. Max. No good there. Georgia Bell. She's going to push the pace again. Allward stalking her from behind. A little 1-2 pass. Wide open three in the corner. No good, but rebounded there from Brooke Reynolds. Screen roll with Reynolds. Reynolds puts the ball on the ground, passes it back to Hoyt. Turns the corner. Bell. Strong on that penetration, but on that shot, but rebounded again. Another attempt, this time from three from Mariah Ward. This time, Allward cleans it up for the Saints. Oh boy, what a pass inside and a catch. McIntyre wasn't able to finish though. Boyd found her. Now, Thulamu have numbers. Ma turns the corner right-handed. Ask me if you've heard this before. She gets into the paint. That right-handed finish attempt from McIntyre, came over there and fouled her on it. She's going to the line. So leaders in the first half, the Saints. Clancy McIntyre with her 10 points and 5 boards. And Ella Hoyt, a little bit of everything. She had a 3, she had 5 boards, she had 3 points, 3 assists, 3 steals, a block, and I don't know, a partridge in a pear tree too for Ella Hoyt. But she's got 3 fouls and she's playing with them. Let's see how long that goes. Missing at the line was Ma, so a 4-point lead still for these Pulumu, and the Saints on the run, knocked out of bounds over there by Bell. Georgia Bell had 5 points. Pardon me, 4 points and five. Pardon me, excuse me, I was right. 5 points in the first half. A couple of assists. Erica Ma led the team with her 9. Sisk had 5. Riley had 4. Everybody, lots of scoring involved. Oh, and a steal there by Bell. Took it away from. That was Burns. Got the ball stolen. Ma didn't quite have the angle there right handed that time. Watched closely by Allward. They're watching a standstill, free, hand down, man
Georgia
down situation.
Bell.
Man down, woman down situation, I should say. Georgia Bell knocked in a 3. Just very kind of lax defense there by the Saints. Like they wanted her to shoot that one. McIntyre, that's a rare find. Just somebody alone in the paint with good position. Saints haven't had a lot of those opportunities. Been an issue. They can't get the paint touches they're normally used to and want. Oh, pass knocked away by Ma, and it's right to Ward. Ward's going to try to go on Hoyt, but Hoyt, in that situation she's in with 3, can't risk the 4th. And now it's a 9-point game. Clancy with the Euro step, trying to finish with the left. Can't, but in good position there was Grace Collins on the offensive glass. They had to knock it away from her out of bounds. Well done there by Collins. Burns checks out as well. Lauren Wells back into the game. Boy, turns the corner. Boy, that was nice, but in and out. Gets her own rebound though, and she's gonna go to the line. Ella Hoyt. She's a little bit tough, is Miss Hoyt. Quick off, she was quickest off the floor after that miss. Didn't hesitate, went right back up amongst the trees. Knew when she'd take contact. Gonna have to try to narrow this lead down. She makes the first, and it's down to 8. So watch that replay. Hoyt, quick off the ground, and Bell tried to stay vertical, but couldn't do it. Foul though was on Reynolds, her 2nd. So it's back to a 7-point game. Oh boy, left her in the dust, and now a 1-2 pass. A good recovery from the Saints, but penetrating into the key there was Sisk, and able to finish. That was well done by the Saints to hit their rotations there. Bell had turned that corner and turned it into a 5-on-4, but McIntyre goes baseline with the crossover. Beautiful stuff, and it's down to 5. Little dribble handoff action here from the pool. We'll get it back to Reynolds. Reynolds and swung all the way over for a long jump shot at three from Mariah Ward. Boy, the three-point shooting and the forcing of turnovers. Defensively, that's the difference right now. Rhea McFarland had to literally push off Verica Ma just to get some space to make a pass out there. Allward tries to drop it inside, but Mariah Ward with the steal. Now Ma up. And now spotting up for three. Just kind of backing up into it, though. She didn't really, was Sisk there. It wasn't really, if she'd have gotten there to that spot as soon as Ma made her move, she would have been able to set her feet and get it up. But Avery Scott now going to check in. She had a really good first half. Only 2 points. Not a lot of stats, but she just was mixing it up defensively, moving the ball well. Hoyt again. Pardon me. Bell again. Just beating that initial defense. And Creighton just advantage situations. Not huge advantage situations, but 5-on-4s where she can create the right angle for some good passes. And Ma caught it and finished from three. Allward can't finish at the other end. Good outlet pass there from Scott. And Ma, she got hit. And it's guess who? Hoyt. And Hoyt can't believe it. Looked like a good call to me, but Hoyt's going to have to check out with four, and she's going to be sitting for a while. It's going to be a full quarter before we see her again, I would imagine. Then again, it's an 11-point lead as we stand, so how long can you wait? Hopefully the Saints can stem this tide a little bit. Wide open, right out of the inbounds. Oh, just can't get that lefty baseline jumper to go. Can Lily Sisk. So the Saints now, can they get that ball into the paint where they like to get it? Clancy McIntyre, oh, can't get the lefty move to go after she gets all the way into the middle of the paint. Ma can't catch that outlet. The kick ahead pass from Avery Scott back to the Saints. Oh boy, they didn't know who was matched up on Clancy there for a minute. Sis got back to her. Nice little pass to Allward. Allward was long, and McIntyre boxed out, stuck it. The box out did Lily Sisk on McIntyre. She had no choice but to go over her back and knock it out of bounds. And this foul trouble for Hoyt is big problems for the Saints. Oh, good hustle. Excellent work from Layla Burns. Getting down on the floor and jumping on it. Georgia Bell thought she had it to herself, but no. Ma turns the corner right-handed. Yeah, it's going to be a travel, yeah. She's so fast. You kind of hold your breath if you're a St. Malachy's fan when she turns the corner right-handed. Just that time, didn't make the right decision. Oh, and Allward catches a tipped pass and lays it in for two. A little bit lucky. But also, Owen reaching in for the steal again. Owen Malachy's creates a turnover, and Allward's going to lay another one in. And now timeout. Olamu and the Saints, little charge, back to within seven. And that defense out there, Layla Burns. On Georgia Bell's been a key. Allison LeBlanc stepped in to help her out and made the easiest, got the easiest assist of her life, just handing it to Ms. Allward. Avery laid it in for two. Allward had a good first half. Only 3 points, one field goal, but eight boards, couple of blocks, couple of assists. She was good, but just like the rest of her team, they shot 33% in that first half, did the Saints, and really only got up 30 shots, which is really a bigger measure. 26% is what the Pulumu shot in that first half, but they got up 11 more shots, and that sometimes is a telling stat. 11 offensive rebounds to 4 in that first half. For the Pulumu. So when you got more possessions, I don't know, it doesn't take rocket science to figure out you're going to have more chances to score. But a little charge here, a little mini charge from St. Max, the last 4 to them. And the manner in which they did it, creating some havoc defensively, it's got the fans interested. Bell. Turn the corner that time easily. Ma, man, she's so quick turning that corner. Bell, she gets into the paint, leaves it there nicely, just can't finish. Consist kind of back rimmed it. The defense there by DeRoche and Ma on McIntyre, but she's able to move it fast. Open three, but a deep one, no good. Ma comes away with it. Crossing over is Avery Scott, getting all the way to the paint. Can't get it to go, though. And McIntyre collects. She kicks it ahead. Somebody wiped out there at half court. And they're now going to blow it dead. And they missed out on a three-pointer. Lancy, but it was smart to blow it dead. Just bad luck there for St. Max. I think Clancy hit her head on the floor pretty hard, but she's shaking it off. Problem was it was a little dangerous, so they blew the play dead as Avery was rising and making a three. So good ball movement by the Saints here, but St. Maliki's read that one. Yeah, that's going to be over the back, though. It was a tough pass through traffic, but Allward used her body well to shield off DeRoche from behind. And that's going to be a foul. 2 fouls apiece now as it's 2:32 on the clock, third quarter. McIntyre gets it back to Allward, back to McIntyre. She's going to pop a jumper, and it's good. Avery. Clancy McIntyre keeping Maliki's in it. Oh, and Bell creates an advantage situation again, but getting back nicely is Burns cutting her off. DeRoche to Bell. Bell's open for three. She's going to try it, but she's short. Good hustle from Sis, but you can't get it back in bounds. Checking out is Avery Scott, and back in comes Mariah Wood. So 5-point game now. St. Max has worked their way back into it. Allward, nice look. Yeah, it was there. McIntyre can't finish, but she's going to the line for two. And Allward and McIntyre chipping away here, bringing Max back into things bit by bit. So McIntyre played basketball for Team NB. She's a twin. Played basketball since the first grade. And it's culminating here in an appearance at TD Center for the provincial championship in her grade 11 year. And she's showing out. That's going to be a double dribble on Miramichi Valley, and it's unraveling a little bit here. Now they've still got a 4-point lead, under 2 minutes left. But just some mistakes creeping into the Pulumu's game that wasn't there. And and St. Max has to be thrilled they're doing with this with Hoyt on the bench. She's going to come back in the fourth. And how close are they going to be? Oh, Allward in and out from three. Rebounded there by Ward. They're going to have to get it over half, and they're not going to. And they turn it over. And laying it in off the feed from Allward is Layla Burns. She's doing some work in this quarter is Layla Burns. And the Pulumu have got to attack. I'm not sure why they're being so passive out of this press. They turned that corner. They were creating such advantages out of that. earlier and attacking, getting easy shots. That's a big one. In and out, and rebounded by St. Max, and they are within two, and they can tie or take the lead. McIntyre trying to get it down low. Well read by the Pulumu, but weren't able to collect it cleanly, and it's a jump ball, and it's staying with St. Max. Checking back in is Ashley Bro, as Layla Burns needs a break. She's holding her side there a little bit. I think she's just spent. She's put a lot into her defense here in this third quarter and has been a big reason why the Saints have crept back into it with Hoyt on the bench. Allward using the screen, turning the corner, not there. McFarland. Only six on the clock. Over there on the sideline was Ward being disruptive. Only six on the clock. Into McIntyre, a little handoff. Oh boy, they went back door. Look at that at the buzzer. Oh boy, they almost had a layup to LeBlanc. Oh, they turned it right back over. Allward lays it in and ties it up. Avery Allward, big third quarter of her own, and the score is tied here at TD Station in the hometown Saints. Causing some havoc on the sideline and a steal. Ahead to McIntyre. Can she lay it in and take the lead? No, but she's going to the line for two free throws. 12.3 on the clock, and what a run here from the Saints. It's an 11-0 run to tie the score with Hoyt on the bench after her fourth. It's been all St. Max. Layla Burns, who's gone to the bench, was incredible in harassing the Pulumu backcourt into turnovers. And Matt Clancy McIntyre gives the Saints the lead. A 12-0 run, looking to make it 13. No, sir. Rebounded by DeRoche. DeRoche knows they only have 10 seconds. They got time. Gonna have to step into one as Mariah Ward, and she knew it. She had it blocked and then blocked at the buzzer by Allward, out of bounds. And we go to the third quarter break with the Pulumu stuck one on their back foot here now on a 12-0 run. It's the St. Malachy Saints, and the favorites have come all the way back to snag the lead here as we head to the fourth quarter. All of a sudden, they're getting those paint touches. Some of the shots are going in, but it's mostly been just havoc created in the backcourt and turnovers, just careless stuff from these Pulumu, just handing the Saints some easy lay-ins. And they got to get back to what their successful little formula was, which was hitting the glass, taking care of the ball, and using that advantage when they, for some reason, they just kind of went away from it. It was George Bell doing such a good job just beating that pressure with one good pass or just pushing the ball ahead off the dribble. And like I said, they weren't, you know, three on ones, but they were creating advantages. Four on threes on one side of the floor, five on four, and she was just getting 2 feet inside the paint and getting to the glass or sharing the ball, and they were attacking the paint off of those passes or getting wide open jumpers. And for some reason, they just got passive out of it a little bit there in the second half of that third quarter. And that was part of the reason that St. Max came charging back into the lead. And now St. Max goes to the fourth, up one. Now, don't go thinking something crazy like the St. Malachy Saints are better. With Ella Hoyt off the floor, it is fortunate they were able to put this run together as Jenna Higgins comes over and talks to her coach. She's on the floor to start this fourth, along with Rhea McFarland and Allward and McIntyre. And Ashley Bro, the 5-4. The Saints. It's Bell. Oh boy, Allward read that. Offensive play coming miles away, but getting back for that block. Beautifully done by Brooke Reynolds. But Allward disrupted that dribble handoff action there. Read it like a book. Oh, and reading the inbounds like a book. Look at Reynolds coming over and ripping it away. It's going to stay with St. Max. But Reynolds, a couple of big defensive plays here. Popping a three from the wing. And telling Lily Sisk about it a little bit was Allward. A little chit-chat there. Oh, looks like it was a long two, not a three. Jenna Higgins there on the foul. Trying to be physical there with Georgia Bell. Into Bell now, looking up at McIntyre. Ma. Reynolds swings it over to Sisk. Sisk now, she's going to attack with the left hand. Gets all the way to the glass, can't finish, and McIntyre collects. So kind of like that first quarter, the Pulumu got behind a little bit. They couldn't finish. Oh, a nice little backdoor look, and coming over for the block. Beautiful by Mariah Ward. Oh, the defensive plays by these two teams. It's been a battle on that end of the floor. Coming back is Hoyt with 9 minutes left in this game. If I'm her, I'm thinking, you know, I could play a little more freely. They've played so well without me. A little hand, dribble handoff, Hoyt, too strong. Sisk dribbles to the corner and picks it up. They're gonna need some help. Oh, they got it. Bell got it on the run. Now she's got this advantage. She should attack. Again, just a little passive. Ma finds reward for a three. No good. And look at that box out by McIntyre. Hoyt now on the push. She looks for McIntyre, but wasn't there. Knocked away. It's saved. And now on the push is going to be Ma. She doesn't have numbers, but she's going to push anyway. Gets it knocked away by Allward, but it's going to stay with Miramichi Valley. Miramichi Valley, it's been a long time since they've scored. It was 42-31. I wish I knew what the time was on that score, but it was 42-31. Since then, it's 14-0 max, and it's been a while since the Pulumu have seen a shot go through the hoop. And if I'm Coach Jim Waters, I'm over there drawing up the two-point play I am most confident with. And so stay tuned after this game, fans. You're going to see the AAA final, which is going to be just as much fun and just as much atmosphere in here for the FHS Blackcats boys and the Leo Hayes Lions boys, the two Fredericton schools. You know, about an hour and a little bit up the road, I'm sure these fans have made the trip. And it's gonna be black and gold and blue and white in here before long, but we've got a good one on the girls' side. 8.5 minutes left, fourth quarter. And these kids are playing their hearts out. This is a defensive battle. Coming out of that huddle. All smiles on the Pulumu. They know. If you'd have told them before the game it's a 3-point game with 8.5 left, they'd have taken it in a heartbeat. We would have kept it a secret that they'd have been on a 14-0 run against them to get to this 3-point margin. Let's see what they've drawn up. It involves Bell popping a three. I don't know if that was the play or not, but it resulted in a good shot. It was in and out. So still, the lid on the hoop for the Pulumu. McIntyre, the close out there. Oh, such an intelligent save there by Allward. Finds its way all the way back around to Layla Burns. She was in and out from three-point land. And back to Miramichi Valley as the Saints knock it out of bounds. Georgia Bell. Yeah, just runs right through Layla Burns, creating it. But again, the first three quarters, the first two and a half quarters, that advantage she was creating was resulting in wide open shots for herself and her teammates. And it's just, I don't know what it is. It's just gone to Max has made a little bit of an adjustment there and stayed home better. I don't know, but it's been turnover central here for the Kulamu for the last half a quarter or more. It is their ball here as they jumped on it on the loose ball on the floor. 10 seconds left on the clock. We'll see what they create here. It's going to be a screen for Bell. She's going to have an open three if she wants it. No. Driving and nice find inside and spinning it home. Beautifully done by Brooke Reynolds. Moving without the ball, helping out her all-star point guard. Finally, the run comes to an end. Boy, it's been a while since Miramichi Valley had a successful run at their end of the floor. But look at that step back two from Maria McFarland. A big one for the senior. And the lead right back to three. Bell now with Allward watching. That's an advantage for Miramichi Valley. Bell gets all the way to the paint. Follows her own shot. Blocked there by McIntyre. Out off of McIntyre. It's going to stay with Miramichi. Love that. That's much more effective there from Georgia Bell. That's the attack. That's the mentality you want to see out of her. Bell with the handoff to Ward. Trying to hand off back to Bell. Bell, wide open three now. She wants it, and she takes it, and she makes it. Huge shot for Georgia. Play some sweet Georgia Brown for Georgia. That ties the game at 47. Hoyt to Allward for three. Allward answers. Big shot from Avery, who's been big in this second half. The three-point lead back to Max. Oh, with the crossover. Georgia inside, back out. Finds her again at the top of the key for another three. Oh, this one in and out, and Allward on the rebound. Good action there from the Kulamu to create another wide open shot for Bell, but just didn't go this time. Inside goes Allward. That's where she hasn't caught it a lot today. That time, found her. She spun it home, and it's a five-point lead for St. Max. And this is how the Saints want to play, getting the ball into the paint. That's better from Bell. It's wide open three. Answer from Ma. Haven't heard from her in a while. That's what Bella was doing through two and a half quarters, creating those advantages and open shots. But they're not getting the stops they got in those first two and a half quarters either here are the Kulamu, but they're back within two. Allward at the high post. That's where she wants it. McIntyre, no, from the baseline, and Ma collects the rebound. Looks like McIntyre, she went down. Looks like she's got a cramp. So they're going to call. So Danny Patterson is listening to his instructions. There to Gwen Shannon, who's going to check in for her first action, the grade 10. As McIntyre's got to come out with that cramp. So it's going to be Shannon stepping in. Gwen Shannon trying to place McIntyre. Easier said than done. She said, you're going to stick to your man and you're going to move that ball on offense. You're going to come out. That's what Danny Patterson told her. Pressure in the backcourt. Bell beats it. Gets 2 feet in the paint again. Spins. Leaves it short. And down comes Hoyt. But she turns it right back over. Ma finds her. Bell. The penetration. Gets into the paint again. Can't finish. Hoyt this time. The solid outlet pass to Burns. And Burns now has a lane. And she's going to try to attack. It's no good. But coming in was Shannon. She couldn't quite finish either. Getting on the floor was Sisk. And she got it loose. And now Miramichi Valley has numbers. Ma finds a wide open Sisk, and Sisk bangs it in, and the lead back to Miramichi Valley in a seesaw fourth quarter. Ooh, are we having fun yet? In the TD Center. Game three has been the best game of the day so far. The AAA Girls Championship on the line. And turned over. No, the fight from Burns. They maintain possession. Now the Bloomer rip it away. And up goes Ma. Ma on the attack. Lays it in. Little Euro step around Hoyt. The lead to three now for Miramichi Valley. Hoyt squeezes through and finds an open three on the wing. No, side rim from Mac McFarland and run down nicely by Ward. Now Ma can push, and she does. Oh, the little fake and the go and the finish. Oh my, Lily Siskin won. I wasn't sure if she knew at first. The reaction was so muted. Look at that fake and the go. Oh, it gets hit from behind. And Sisk, I think these girls are so exhausted from playing 40 minutes of defense this hard. They didn't have it in them to celebrate. The fans, they don't feel the same way. They got a celebration or two in them and an 8-0 run now for the Pulumu and the lead back to six. 3:37 on the clock. Allward, she turns the corner and pops a three. It's long. The rebound to Georgia Bell, and all of a sudden, everything coming up Miramichi Valley here. Bell with the look inside, and the finish from Sitz, the lefty banker. 8-point lead, the Pulumu. Oh, the pass ahead. That looks like a travel, no. Knocked to the corner by Mariah Ward. They don't need to push. But that's going to be a three from the wing, and the bank is open in TD Station. Brooke Reynolds with the biggest shot of the game, and the three-pointer puts them up 11. Allward forces her way in to the paint. She takes some contact, and she has a chance now to bring it back to single digits. And ever since McIntyre went out, the tide turned. Not the fault of Gwen Shannon by any stretch of the imagination when she came in for her minutes or anything like that. She checks out. Lauren Wells checks out. Ashley Bro back in. I did see Clancy McIntyre come to Coach Patterson and say, I'm ready to go back in. She's got some tape around that calf. But she's going to come back in and leads down to nine. Nice work there by the Pulumu getting that ball in. But Hoyt, she's going to pester Mariah Ward as best she can. Oh, the crossover and the gift in the paint. Look at that 1-2 pass. Beautiful stuff from Reynolds. Open three and then follows the shot, does Reynolds. Can't get it to go, though. Allward took it from Sisk. Now baseline jumper. This one's got to go if you're a Saints fan. It does. A big one from Ashley Bro, and it's down to seven. We still got ourselves a game. Oh, nice work there from Bell on the floater. Too strong. Batted to McFarland and Hoyt, and now Allward. Oh, almost picked off by Sisk. And then good defense there from Ward. Now Allward's going to try a three anyway. No good. Ma comes in there and takes it away. Gives it to Sisk. Sisk now back to Ma. Ma loses it. Boy, that should have been a no call from where I'm looking. Looked like Ma was off balance before any contact. Just kind of went down. Should have been a no call. No free throws. Only the third foul, for St. Max. Only one foul on Miramichi Valley. Oh, and the pass on the side came in. The reward on the sideline. She had on her size 9, should have worn the size 8s. Those heels were on the sideline. So it's still 7. Clancy McIntyre still not back on the floor. Allward turns the corner, hands it off. Oh no, pardon me, McIntyre is on the floor, excuse me. Oh boy. The only one of me, I can't see everything, including, you know, when the best player on the team's back on the floor. How can I be expected to notice? McIntyre a little high, but he's tipped away. In comes Layla Burns back for Allison LeBlanc. LeBlanc, good minutes for her. She was pesky defensively, as Max needs her to be. But Burns' defense has been terrific here in the second half. This is a big one for Hoyt. Oh, side rims the 3. And a big rebound. Oh, boy, that was a risky pass, but it paid off. Smart from Hoyt to pull it back. There's a big 3 from the wing for Bell. In and out. Kind of early, maybe. Didn't need it. Yeah, and I think Coach Waters on the sidelines, like, we could have run 10 more seconds. Now there's another big 3. Hoyt is short that time. Bell to Hoyt. Or pardon me, I think that's Sisk, excuse me, not Hoyt. That's going to be a jump ball and back to Max. And Jim Waters looks at his team and points at the clock. That's all he's got. That's the only message he's got to send. Both ends of the floor. Guys, we're in the lead by 7. The clock is our friend. Let's watch our shot selection. Let's not be crazy in the backcourt as Allward sneaks into the paint and finishes, and we're back to 5. And a turnover. Jumping on it there is guess who? Burns, but can't finish. Ken Hoyt. And another risky pass, but it got there, but no, fouled, and she's going to the line for 2. On the side of the head, says the referee. Did Brooke Reynolds take the contact? And Hoyt, you can see the emotion on her face already. And Coach Patterson's trying to get her to refocus. It's a 5-point game here with 37 seconds left, and they just missed a free throw. Focus up. You didn't cost us anything. I could tell that's kind of what she was saying over there. A missed free throw, but look at Fitz get in there and rip it away. Huge for Miramichi Valley. On the sideline, they got to get it out of there. And now she's going to get called for a travel, and she does. But valuable time went off as well there. That's 10 seconds that's going to matter here for St. Max. And another thing that's going to matter here. No, pardon me. They're up to 4 fouls, excuse me. So they can foul and put Miramichi Valley on the line. But that was... Okay, she traveled to Lily Sisk, yes, but she's also the one that got the offensive rebound and took 10 seconds off the clock in doing it, because that ball went to the sideline. There was a fight back and forth. A good 10 seconds went off the clock, so that's a huge offensive rebound. Yeah, St. Max has it back with 27 seconds left, and that means they are in the game. It's only a 2-possession game. So St. Max is going to have to run their best stuff here. And they're going to have to look for a steal in the backcourt and then foul. They got enough time. If they can get a quick score, they got enough time to let a few seconds come off the clock, see if they can create a turnover before they start fouling. But you got to have a chat about how much time you're going to give them. And hopefully good coaches have done these game situations in their practices before. You know, put 30 seconds on the clock. Hey, guys, we're up 5. What are we going to do here? And it is an absolute zoo with TD Center. TD Station, pardon me. This is fun. Both the Boulamou fans and the Saints fans love the song choice. I'll tell you that right now. But those Boulamou fans are jumping. Their team with a 5-point lead and 27 seconds left. They get the ball in, but it's in the corner and knocked away by Mariah Ward. And she's another member of this team, Mariah Ward. She's not going to win player of the game. She doesn't have a lot of stats in the stat sheet. She's just been disruptive for the Saints. On the Saints, pardon me. Oh, and McIntyre with the step in and the finish. Massive. Now, how much time do you give? Oh, that's a good play by the Pulumu, and they get it over half. And Hoyt gets it stolen by McIntyre, but it's stolen right back. And Allward's got no choice but to commit a foul. Oh, my. As it's been all game, the defenses are the ones stepping up and making the big plays. Hoyt had it taken away over there, but then at half court, Ma comes back with the steal right away. And Allward had no choice but to foul and put her on the line. So it's a three-point game. 9.4 left now. All that matters is that's smart by Georgia. I don't know if Coach Waters told her to, but she said, hey, come off that line. Come here and talk to me. Huge free throws. The first one's a miss. Ma, though, has one more chance to make this a two-possession game. Huge free throw for Ma. Back rims, but there's a rebound ripped away by Reynolds. Now they've got a foul again, and the time's running out. Are they going to get one in time? They're not going to. The game's going to be effectively over. 0.3 on the clock in the Pulumu. It's the ear of the fish. TD Station. 0.3 on the clock only. Back rims the first. And he's gonna be a timeout. Yeah, get everybody out of there. Only bad things can happen. And Reynolds is like, don't worry, I got this, coach. I'm not gonna do anything crazy. And the ball is rebounded. It's too late. And the Pulumu with the upset. And they're the AAA Girls Champions, NBIAA 2022-2023. What a big win for Miramichi Valley and the fans. They went through a loss on the boys' side, and the girls say, we got you, and bring home a banner. Amazing stuff. Late. They were up big. They gave up the lead. They got down big. And then had a run in them late. They stole the lead back, and they're the provincial champs. Miramichi Valley. Players of the game, there's some candidates. I think it's going to be Georgia Bell. I don't think really player of the game. There's some heroes. Brooke Reynolds with some huge plays late. Lily Sisk was so tough. Of course, Erica Ma, some big threes and disruptive defensively. Mariah Ward, I said her value. Riley Duffy put in some good minutes there, coming off the bench, the grade 12. But my goodness, great stuff all the way around, and so disappointing for these Saints. They had chances late, came back and took the lead, but you can see it's all over Ella Hoyt's face. She's gonna, you could tell, she was already, the conversation she was having, she'd already kind of blamed herself a little bit there late. I don't know whether it's the foul trouble, the missed layup she had, but I mean, look, these girls don't make it here without her. You always do that to yourself a little bit if you're a player, one of the important players on your team. If you don't come out and wait for the victory, you're blaming yourself if you don't have the game you're used to. But yeah, Avery Allward, it's a fine choice. Lancey McIntyre was a good choice too, but tie goes to the grade 12, I think. Yeah, Georgia Ma. Pardon me. Georgia Bell, player of the game. And a fine choice. So, fans, this has been a fun one. We got one more later. 45 minutes to go until the boys' championship game. I'm going to sign off now. You watch the awards presentation, and we'll see you back here in 45.
Number one, Ava Mason. Number two, Jenna Higgins. Number three, senior Rhea McFarlane. Number five, senior Ella Hoyt. Number six, Allison LeBlanc. Number seven, senior Avery Alward. Number eight, senior Layla Burns. Number nine, Gwen Shannon. Number 10, Clancy McIntyre. Number 11, Lauren Wells. Number 12, Ashley Bro. Number 13, Grace Collins. Manager, Kyra Marks. Assistant coaches, Sheldon Allward, Heidi Mitchell, and Julie Durantz. And coach Dan Patterson. Would Jim Waters of Miramichi Valley High School please come forward to hand out the gold medals to his team? Number three, Erica Ma. Number four, senior Georgia Bell. Number five, senior Gracie Burns. Number six, senior Avery Scott. Number seven, Mariah Ward. Number nine, senior Olivia Kelly. Number 10, senior Lily Sisk. Number eight, Brooke Reynolds. Number 12, Addison Swain. Number 13, Gracie Goodfellow. Number 14, senior Tyra DeRoche. And number 15, senior Riley Duffy. Manager Arthur Grimley. Assistant coaches Ian Waters and Tom Burns. And coach Jim Waters. Allison Ouellette, Executive Director of the NBIA, will now present the captains of St. Malachy's High School, the NBIAA AAA Girls Runner-Up Plaque. The Final 12 chairperson, Dave Shields, will now present the game ball to the coach of the AAA Girls Champions, Miramichi Valley High School. Allison Ouellette, Executive Director of the NBIAA, will now present the championship banner to the captains of the 2023 AAA Girls Champions from Miramichi Valley High School. Congratulations to both teams, and thank you for supporting high school basketball. Reminder that pictures are to be taken at the west end of Harbor Station in the mixing area. All fans are reminded to stay off the court, please. Thank you for your cooperation in this matter. Next game is the AAA Boys Championship featuring Fredericton High School and Leo Hayes.